This tutorial shows the calculation of the effect size following a significant two-sample t-test. The first step is installing a new package called lsr, using the install.packages and library function. The second step is using the cohensD function, which calculates cohensD. The test variable and the group variable have to be entered into this function, separated by the tilde symbol. The syntax is the same as for the t.test function. After running this line, you will only get one number as output, cohensD. In my case, it is 0.875 rounded to 3 decimals. The third step is to classify the magnitude of this effect. If similar studies in your research field exist, compare your effect size with the given one. If no comparable studies exist, use the common thresholds within your research field. If those are also non-existent, you can refer to Cohen 92, a power primer. Page 157 shows 3 thresholds for the two-sample t-test. If your cohensD exceeds 0.2, it is a small effect. If it exceeds 0.5, it is a medium effect. And if it exceeds 0.8, it can be classified as a large effect, as is the case in my example. When you're done, you have to write up the results. The video that appears now will show you how.